Now let's consider how to do a volume integral in rectangular coordinates. Let's say that I have a charge density that is 4 coulombs per meter cubed, and it goes from x equals 0 to 1.5, it goes from y equals 0 to 2, and it goes from z equals 0 to 3, and I want to know the total charge. Well, I'd handle this just as I did before, and I would take my charge density, and I would multiply by the volume of my box, which would be 1.5 for x, 2 for y, and 3 for z, and this would give me my total charge. Let's see how to do this with a volume integral. A volume integral is going to be a triple integral. I'm going to bring my function right here, 4 coulombs per meter cubed, and then I'm going to use my volume. This is dv, so I'm just going to put that right here, dx, dy, and dz. X varies from 0 to 1.5, y varies from 0 to 2, and z varies from 0 to 3. So let's do the integral. It's going to be 4x from 0 to 1.5, y from 0 to 2, and z from 0 to 3. That's going to give me 4 times 1.5 times 2 times 3, which is exactly the same thing that I had up there. Now let's do what we did before. Let's imagine what would happen if instead of having a constant charge density, let's suppose that my charge density increases as it moves in the y direction. Then I would simply put that down here as my function, and when I integrated, I would have gotten y squared over 2, which would have changed this value right here. So you can see that I could very easily use my volume integral in this form to be able to handle any sort of function. If I had tried to do that right here, this would not have been my total charge. I couldn't simply multiply my variable charge density by the volume of the box. So this method of being able to do integrals is very important anytime you have a non-uniform value that you want to be able to do a volume integral of.